I guess this is the movable blade support, so this is the one that you can slide in and out for different widths of cut. And then there's this piece with the blade guide bearings on it, so it's pretty much like the other side. And this one just has a narrow slot so you can adjust the height to get this inner bearing, the thrust bearing, to line up. The blade coolant screws in here, and then you have this screw goes in there and into there, and then that lets you, like I say, adjust the height up and down. So this one, many years ago, this cast iron piece broke. You can see it cracked in the middle there and then cracked through these holes all the way across, pretty thin cross section. So I welded this all back together, and then I welded this piece of steel across the face here to give it a little extra support, because I couldn't really weld this very good here. Yeah, it was about 10 years ago, I think, that it broke on me, and that bearing was just packed in there, and you can see it's been really cut in deep. It hasn't been rotating all that well. There's probably the last spot where it's jammed. So I gotta get new bearings in here. I got this all cleaned up on the wire wheel. So I may have, when I popped the bearing out, I might have lost my other washer. So I might have to get another one of those. So I'll show you what this looks like when I get it put together. Okay, got the bearings back in there. Just got this on there loose, because you still have to set the thrust bearing height. So you've got the one thrust bearing that the back of the blade rides on that, and then you've got the two side support bearings. So these are ABEC 6000 bearings. I think they went up in price. They're almost $15 a piece. So I think next time I might look into doing ceramic bearings here, because then I wouldn't have the problem of rust like that, because that seems to be what kills these. They start getting rusty in there. Like, some of them are okay, but then other ones are, like these guys, are just completely solid. So I don't know if that's rust from the metal inside, or is it the iron? Because the other problem you get is there's a lot of iron dissolved in the coolant that you pump through the machine. So these bearings run wet most of the time, and that water dissolves the iron that you're cutting if you're mainly cutting steel. So you get a lot of that in there, and these things get seized up solid like that. So that's about 5 years on a set of bearings. So anyway, got to put this back on the saw, and then we'll get everything lined up and see what it looks like. I guess this technique is what I've found works the best for setting the blade so it cuts straight. So yeah, what I do is just keep enough tension on the screw to hold that in place, and then because it's rather tight, I put a pipe wrench over there and I can twist that blade guide, and then I use a right angle here, machinist square, and then you can usually check. So what you want to do is like get a little flashlight here and shine the light in from behind, and you can see down the gap between the square and the blade. You have to look for a small gap in there because the teeth have set, so you can't push the square all the way up against the blade because the teeth are on the bottom. Maybe I can get the camera on that. Yeah, so here we go. See if you can see a little bit of light gap. Actually, I think I need to go a little bit more. And then you have to move the square, because as you rotate it, it moves the blade out a little bit. Yeah, I think just a little more. So I've gone a little too far, because there's a slight bit more gap on the bottom. Okay, I think I got everything in position, and then what you need to do is hold down on the pipe wrench in that direction while you push down on the Allen key in the opposite direction. So if you get about that far, so you got the same moment arm there, because you don't want to bump this setting here. So let's see if that does the trick there. I think that's pretty square. And let me just check. I got to check this side too. Yeah, that looks good. And then the only other thing you have to set is I set the thrust wheel here just at the top of the blade. Oh yeah, much quieter. Boy, that it was making quite a bit of noise because these bearings were all either seized up or they were completely dry. Oh, that's the other thing. I got to put my coolant line back in here because you have to leave this coolant pipe loose because you have to get to this Allen head screw right here and the pipe's right in front of it. Oh, there we go. Yeah, I got it. You just have to wiggle it around enough to get it lined up. There we go. Yeah, I'll get a wrench on there, tighten that up before I run any coolant through it. Okay, here's a first cut YouTube. So I'll just show you how I check the square here. So that was the top of my cut right there. So I put my straight edge and you can see it's just a slight gap. So it says the blade was cutting, if we get that in shot, it was cutting slightly out. So I have to, let's see, is that right? Yeah, so the bottom, it was cutting slightly away from the saw, so I need to tip it back. I went too far counterclockwise. I got to come clockwise just a bit. And when you get really close like this, then usually what I'll do is put my part, because I'm moving the blade in towards the saw body. So if I leave a little bit of a gap, that way I can kind of see when I've moved it a little bit. I'll loosen this up just a bit, bump the blade clockwise a little bit, and then I have to move the wrench to the other side to tighten the thing back down. But yeah, we're pretty close. I think I'm probably within a degree. In fact, I could probably check that. Yeah, I'm within about a quarter degree there, 89.75 degrees. So that was pretty close for a first shot. Yeah, I'm just trying to get that last quarter degree dialed in. But yeah, just show you my calibration process. There's probably other ways to do it, but I find the acid test is how straight is the cut. The blade could be all over the place, but it's how square is that cut. That's what matters. Okay, YouTube, I got it dialed in pretty square, and you can really see how square it is. This is just right off the saw, chucked up in the lathe. And there you can see that. There's like no run out on that. So if you make a nice square cut like that, even though I'm going to square this up on the lathe, all it takes is a really light pass. I don't have to make multiple passes if it was really out of round, or out of square, I guess it would be. So yeah, it just makes your life easier, and you don't have to waste as much material, because if your cuts are really crooked, you've got to add extra length to the raw part, so that by the time you turn it down square, it's still of the appropriate size. So making square cuts is definitely saves you time, saves you material. That is nice and square, so I think we're good to go.